क्लास 11th बायोलॉजी। टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग न्यू चैप्टर्स फ्रॉम यूनिट 3rd सेल द यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ। एज यू नो एवरी ऑर्गेनिज्म इज मेड अप ऑफ सेल और सेल्स विच आर वेरी माइन्यूट इन साइज बट वेरी मच डायनेमिक फिजियोलॉजिकली एंड मेटाबॉलिकली। These cells are the fundamental basic unit of life, both by structural and functions. These build the body structure and carry out all the functions essential for life. In unicellular organism like amoeba, paramecium, a single cell performs all the activities. However, in multicellular organism, there is physiological division of labor among cells. Cells are organized into tissue form organ form organ system and different organ system form the whole organism. A cell can be defined time to time by many scientists in different ways. A cell is the structural and functional unit of living beings. A cell is the basic unit of life. A cell is the small mass of living matter or protoplasm. Cell is the smallest living unit which can survive independently. A cell is the piece of unnucleated cytoplasm surrounded by a cell membrane which may exist singly or in groups. Lowy and Sikebits 1963 defined the cell as the unit of biological activity surrounded by permeable membrane and capable of self-reproduction in a medium free of other living system. However, not a single definition of cell is perfect and accepted by the scientific community. Cell as a basic unit of life. All the organisms of earth are made up of either one or more than one cells. In multicellular organisms, a group of cells with similar structure, origin and function to make a tissue. According to their function, tissue becomes morphologically different. This is known as cellular differentiation. In a multicellular organism, different functions are performed by different tissues. This is known as division of labor. While in a unicellular organism, all the vital functions are performed by a single cell, hence division of labor is absent in them. Group of tissue further organized to form organ, like leaf of the plant that is made up of chlorophyllous tissue or chlorenchyma. Like by stomach, ovary, kidney, brain or different organ of the animals. A group of organs which work in coordination and perform major function of the body form organ system. For example, digestive system consists of mouth, buccal cavity, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, intestine, liver and pancreas. Vascular system consists of heart, blood vessels and blood. Excretory system consists of kidney, ureter, urinary bladder, urethra, etc. All these organs perform major function in the body. Various organ system further work in a coordination to form an organism. History of cell or discovery of cell. The history of cell discovery begins with the publication of book Micrographia in London by Robert Hooke in 1965. The word cell, cella means a small compartment, was introduced in 1665 by Robert Hooke. He observed honeycomb-like structure in a thin slice of cork with the help of a microscope developed by himself. This microscope was light microscopes under which in a slice of honeycombs he observed compartmentations honeycomb like structures and Anton von Leeuwenhoek invented compound microscopes and studied many unicellular organisms by magnifying them in 1667 and was the first to see free cells. He observed bacteria, protozoa, red blood cells, sperm, etc. In 1682, Andrew proposed the cell concept. According to his cell concept, cell is the structural unit of all living beings. He has also studied many plant tissue. In 1831, Robert Brown discovered that there is a particular structure present in the center of cell of root of orchid. This centrally situated part was named as nucleus. So cell is discovered by Robert Hooke and nucleus is discovered by Robert Brown. Kotai, 1772, first pointed out that living cell contained some liquid substance and it was named saccharin by Tujardins in 1836. Hugo von Mol observed similar liquid substance present within the cell. Purkinje in 1840 named this liquid substance of cell as protoplasm. Huxley went a step further and called it as the physical basis of life. In 1932, Nall and Ruska invented electron microscope. Claude and Pallet in 1974 studied ultrastructure of cell by the help of electron microscope. For this, they have been awarded by Nobel Prize. Some other important achievements that lead to easy understanding of cells are nucleic acid DNA and RNA were discovered by Frederick Mischler, 1869. Process of cell division by discovered by W. Fleming in 1879. Chromosome were discovered by Baldeyer in 1988 in dividing cells. Mitochondria was discovered by R. Ottman 1890 and C. Benda 1897. Electron microscope was invented in the 20th century. The ultrastructure of a living cells could be studied with the help of this microscope. Our present knowledge of cell structure is based on such electron microscopic study. The cell theory. The concept that cell is the basic unit of life is known as cell theory or cell doctrine. First attempt to present a theory regarding cellular organization of living beings was made by a French scientist, H.I. Dutrochet, 1824. In this context, he postulated two views. Every organism is composed of cells, and second, cell is the basic unit of all organisms. The actual cell theory was proposed by M. J. Schleiden, 1804 to 1881, a German botanist. He found that all plant tissue were made of one or the other kind of cells. Therefore, Schleiden concluded that cells constitute the ultimate units of all plant tissue. In other words, cells are organisms and entire plants and animals are aggregation of these organisms arranged according to definite law. In 1839, Theodore Schön, a German zoologist studies different type of animal tissue, including the development of embryo. He concludes that all the organisms are composed of essentially like parts, namely cells. Combined view of Sladen and Swan led to the formulation of cell theory. This theory proposed that all living beings, whether plants or animals, are composed of an assemblage of cells which arise from the pre-existing cells, and that the activities of an organism are outcome of the activities of its constituent cells. Sladen and Swan are, however, credited with formulating the observation in the form of a theory. This theory was, however, not able to explain how new cells are formed. Rudolf Virchow, 1855, modified the cell theory and states that new cells develop from the division of pre-existing cells. Omnicellular e cellular. It is known as law of cell lineage. Fundamental features of cell theory are that all living organisms are composed of different types of cells and their products. All cells arise from pre-existing cells. All the activities of an organism are outcome of the activities of its constituent cells. All cells are basically identical in their chemistry and physiology. Each cell is made up of protoplasm having a nucleus and is bounded by a cell membrane with or without cell wall. Objections are shortcomings of cell theory. Swan, for instance, believed that the cell could be spontaneously generated. Means they suddenly generated in the nature. But the studies of developing embryos show that during growth, cells duplicate themselves by division. In many organisms, body is not differentiated into cells, so it may have numerous nuclei, cenocytic cells, as in fungi, rhizopus. Sladen and Swan did not know the mechanism of cell formation. Sladen thought that new cells were developed from nucleus or cryptoblast. Swan believed that cells were developed spontaneously like a crystal. So now the cell theory versus cell principle. The modern cell theory or cell principle is better than cell theory because of the following reasons. Cell principle is applicable for almost to all living things, microorganisms, plants and animals. It incorporates nearly all the modern findings about a cell. So after studying the cell theory and cell principle, a modern cell theory or cell principle is given. Modern cell theory or cell principle. Cell principle is the modified or modern form of cell theory. It is also known to be a cell doctrine or cell principle. Cell theory stands today as cell principle. The cell principle states that all organisms are composed of cells and their products. New cells arise from pre-existing cells. All cells are basically alike in chemical composition and metabolic activities. All the activities of an organism as a whole is the outcome of the activities and interaction of the constituting cells of the body of that organism. Each cell is made up of a small mass of protoplasm having a nucleus bounded by a cell membrane with or without a cell wall. Cells are the hereditary unit of life as it contains hereditary substance in its nucleus. Growth of an organism involves the growth and multiplication of its cells. Genetic informations are stored and expressed inside the cell. Basically, all the cells are totipotent, means ability of a single cell to grow into whole organism is called totipotency. Each cell maintains its individuality. It has a specific internal environment and homeostasis. There are some exceptions of cell theory or cell principles also. It means nothing is fulfilled in itself. Viruses are the good example of exception of the cell theory because virus is acellular organism. They lack cytoplasm, the essential part of the cell. They are made up of protein covering and nucleic acid DNA or RNA only. Virus do have enzyme system and depend on enzyme system of host cells. In virus body, there is no any enzyme system of the viruses itself, but they depends on enzyme system of host which is infected by viruses. This is the reason why viruses multiply only inside living cells and are called obligatory parasites. Other exceptions is synocytic cells, the cells which have more than one nucleus within a single cell or multinucleated cells are called synocytic cells, like fungus rhizopus and algae like Bucheria are accepted and multinucleated. This condition remains unexplained in cell theory. Third exception, bacteria and cyanobacteria, prokaryotes. They lack well organized nucleus, nuclear membrane, nucleolus and nucleoplasm are absent. Chromatin is in direct contact with cytoplasm. The nucleic acid DNA alone forms the chromosome and lies in direct contact with cytoplasm. So these are the exceptions of cell theory or modern cell theory, cell principle, which were not explained in the cell principles.
रुक कैसे गया है? इस क्वेश्चन में रोकना पड़ेगा ना जहां